We was on the bottom, yeah. Now we headed to the top, new level. On my level, don't see anybody, I don't see him. This right here could never stop, this could never stop. Hey, this right here could never stop, hold up, nah, nah. Hey, this right here could never stop, hold up, nah, nah. Hey, this right here could never stop, hold up, nah, nah. Hey, this right here could never stop, hold up, nah, nah. One time, hey. I live on a job, right? Yeah, I'm always at work, right? Real people stay by me, right? Haters wanna do hurt, right? Know they tryna stop me, right? Drag my name through dirt, right? I don't feed them to the hate, right? I just answer with a smirk, facts. I feel so special, facts. I know my worth, facts. My bloodline royal, facts. We the kings of the earth, right? You can't stop this, nah, nah. You can't stop this, no way.
What have you learned since you've been up here? Explain to me. Okay, who are you? According to the Bible, who are you? It's right there.
He said he is descended from the white man, Irish.
No. You're right. You're Israelite, and your tribe is Levi, according to the Bible, right? So, as the brother was getting into, we have to repent, right? Give me Acts chapter 3, verse 19, first. Because do they ever teach you that? You go to church. You know, what you go to, a Christian church? Christian church, right? It's just like me. I used to go to the Christian church before I found out about the truth. And they don't teach us how to truly repent according to the Bible.
Right.
But we're going to read the Bible, and we're going to see how we're supposed to repent. All right, Matthew? Read that.
This is the book of Acts, chapter 3, and verse 19. Repent ye therefore and be converted, that your sins may be blotted out.
So the Bible says, repent therefore and be converted. What does converted mean?
It has a red clip.
Like if you say, I'll give you an example. If you say, I'm going to go and convert. I say, I'm going to go convert this blue shirt to a red shirt. What did you just do to the shirt colors? No, let's say, I'm going to go convert this dollar into four quarters. What do you just go do? It's a word. It starts with a C. It means to change. So right here, the Bible is saying that we as a people have to change. Because remember what you said before, you're in the Christian church. The Christian church does not teach us how to change. And I'm going to give you a law according to the Bible that you can start keeping right now. Give me Leviticus 13 first. Leviticus 13, verse 30. You said before that your father was so-called French, right? Right? So my question is, your hair, right? We went over Christ's image, how he looks like, right? Did you blonde your hair or did you bleach it like that? Give me Proverbs 3:31 first. Huh? Did you blonde your hair? Yeah. Why did you blonde your hair? It's a style, right? So my question is, who taught you that style? I know how it is. Dudes get dread. All of a sudden, they want to bleach it because they think it looks cool. It's a style. But who taught you that? Huh? You said society. See, now I like that answer because that's a true answer. You're being honest. But guess what? We got to stop letting society teach us what to do with our lives.
That's right.
Because society is only going to teach us. Society's not going to teach us God's laws. Society's laws is you don't have to get married. You can have a boyfriend and girlfriend. You can bleach your hair. You can smoke weed. You can party all day. You can go in the club. But God doesn't condone any of that stuff. Watch this. Read.
This is the book of Proverbs, chapter 3, and verse 31.
Uh-huh.
Envy thou not the oppressor.
So God says, don't envy the oppressor. The oppressor is your enemy, Matthew. The so-called white man, whether it's French, German, whatever, the Caucasian race. God says, don't be jealous of your enemy or what he does. Read.
Envy not thou oppressor, and choose none of his ways.
God says, choose none of his ways. Don't try to be like them. Because guess who we got the blonding our hair from? Who do we get the blonding the hair from? Who's blonde on the face? Who has blonde hair on the face of the earth? Isn't blonde a French word? What does the word blonde mean? Blonde? Yeah, blonde. B-L-O-N-D. I'm listening. Do you know the definition of it? Blonde means yellow in French. So right now, when you blonde your hair, you put yellow coloring in it, right? But who are you trying to look like? You're just you. Okay, you say you're just you. Read that again.
This is the book of Proverbs, chapter 3 and verse 31. Envy thou not the oppressor, and choose none of his ways.
God says don't choose any of your oppressor's ways, because that's how you got Matthew. You got it from so-called white people, bro.
Right.
You say you got it because, you know, society, that's what they teach. But our people, we do the things that the other nations do. The so-called white people, Chinese, and any other race. Now go to Leviticus 13:30, because I'm gonna give you the law that God says you cannot blonde your hair, bro. Your hair is perfectly fine the way it is. You have the same hair as God. Did you know that? You're created in God's image. God looks just like me and you, a so-called black man. But you're trying to look like a white man. You see the problem with that? Okay, but guess what? According to the Bible, that's still a law that you're breaking. You're not supposed to dye your hair blonde, or any color for that matter. And we're going to read that right now. Read.
This is the book of Leviticus, chapter 13 and verse 30.
Come on.
Then the priest shall see the plague.
See, the priests in the Bible are the Levites. Me and you, my father's a so-called Haitian too. But according to the Bible, I'm from the nation of Israel, from the tribe of Levi. That's who me and you are. Read.
Then the priest shall see the plague. And behold, if it be in sight deeper than the skin, and there be a yellow thin hair.
A what?
A yellow thin hair.
It said if there's a yellow thin hair, like you have on your hair. Read.
Then the priest shall pronounce him unclean. It is a dry scalp. Even the leprosy upon the head or beard.
You see that, Matthew? God says it is a leprosy. That's a disease, bro. So you look just like God. You look like the spitting image of God, literally. But you want to dye your hair color to look like someone who's diseased.
Right.
You don't want to look like that, bro. You're perfectly fine. So when you go home, what are you going to do with that bleach or blonde in your hair? What are you going to do? No, not what I say. It's what the Bible says. So are you going to take that bleach or yellow blonde hair out your hair? All praises. All praises. So, Matthew, I got a question for you. How old are you? You're 27. Oh, damn, bro. I thought you was younger than me. Okay, so I'm 24. I got a question. Do you have a girlfriend? I see you smiling. You don't got a lot of me, bro. I know how it is. You single. Are you messing with anybody on the side? Are you messing with anybody on the side? You're messing with somebody. Like you're talking to them, texting. Are you sleeping with that sister? Soit couché avec. No? Okay. Give me Hebrews chapter 13, verse 4 first. The reason I ask that is because another thing the Bible condemns as us being the Israelites, we can't have girlfriend and boyfriend, bro. We can't deal like that with each other. In the Bible, there's no such thing as girlfriend, boyfriend, or friends with benefits or anything like that. Even if you're talking to someone. Like if you try to go on Instagram, you got Instagram? Facebook? What's that? WhatsApp? You got WhatsApp? When you try to hit up females on those type of apps, God said you can't be doing that. Because the first thing you're thinking about is not to marry that woman. The first thing you want to do is what? But if you talk, you try to what? You can be honest with me, bro. You can be honest with me. God used to do the same thing. But watch what God says about that. Read that.
This is the book of Hebrews, chapter 13 and verse 4.
Before we read the scripture, this woman that you mentioned with, is she so-called black, Hispanic, or Native American? Is she from the nation of Israel? She's from the nation of Israel. So she ain't white, she ain't Asian, she ain't Chinese. She's not none of those races. So what is she? So-called black, African-American, Haitian, Puerto Rican? Do you know, or you just started talking just to, you know, get... Okay, I see. All right, read that. Watch what God says about that. Read.
This is the book of Hebrews, chapter 13 and verse 4. Marriage is honorable in all.
So you said you're 27, right? You said you're messing with this girl. Are you ready to marry that woman? If you're ready to marry her, you look nervous. So my other question is, since you talked to this girl, how long have you been talking to her? Has it been 2 months, a week? What do you mean it depends on the situation? How long you been talking to her? Like how long you been texting her or hitting her up on social media, talking on the phone? 1 month? 1 month. So you say you didn't sleep with her, but did you touch on her that's inappropriate? Have you touched on her, kiss her, anything like that? You did all that, right? Now, do you think God is okay with you doing that? Be honest, do you think God is okay with you doing that? Bro, I'm not that far from age from you, bro. I know how it is. You think God is okay with that? No, you don't, right? All right, but we're going to read it out of the Bible. Read.
Marriage is honorable in all, and the bed undefiled.
So it says marriage is honorable, a man and a woman, because I know America teaches us in this country that a man and a man can get married, a woman and a woman can get married. That's false. Like you said, society teaches us these things, but they're not according to the Bible. God says a marriage between a man and a woman. Read.
But whoremongers and adulterers.
It says whoremongers. Do you know what a whoremonger is? A whoremonger is someone that sleeps from man to man to man, woman to woman with woman, that has multiple partners. And in America, they teach that lifestyle is okay. But guess what? Don't we have single-parent households? Right? Don't we have the highest rate of STDs, HIV? So by you doing that, that's not okay, that she's not your wife. God says marriage is honorable. Whatever a husband and a wife do in the bed, that's between them. It's fine. And you say you've been talking to this girl for a month. So you telling me you're ready to get married after a month, Matthew? After 1 month? That's it. You know, marriage is a big commitment. What do you mean it depends on the girl? Explain. I'm listening. The right things? Okay. Okay. So Rock 6 and 7. I'm glad you said that. So Matthew, you said it depends on how she treats you. It depends on her behavior. You don't think that it depends on the time. Actually, the Bible says different. It does. A lot of it depends on the time. You got to take time to get to know the person.
This is the book of Sirach, chapter 6 and verse 7.
This is why it actually does take time to get to know somebody you're going to marry one day. Read.
If thou would have said a friend.
If you want a friend. Before, I'm not talking about a girlfriend, I'm talking about boyfriend. Before you want to get, in your case, a wife, not a girlfriend, you have to do what? You have to prove that person first. What does it mean you have to prove that person? What does it mean if I'm going to prove you? I need to see what you're about. That's what it means. Like you said before, you need to see if she's going to be good behavior. You need to see if she's going to be a good wife to you and a good mother to your future kids, maybe. You, bro, Matthew, I'm gonna be real with you. You won't know a woman just after 1 month, bro. Because women can play it. They can play it real for years, bro. For years. And I don't want you to be that dude. Like, pay attention. Don't worry about them. The devil's trying to distract you. I don't want you to be that dude that gets to know a woman for 1 year, you have sex with her, and next thing you know, she gets pregnant with them. You got a job, Matthew? You don't got a job. So, Matthew, I got to be real with you, bro. Hold that. Give me Exodus 22:16. Because you said you was talking to the girl. So that means you was playing game, right? Yeah, you saying some things, trying to get her to giggle, trying to get her to laugh, you know. Your voice got low over the phone, you know. And then late at night, y'all not talking about God's laws, I guarantee it. Because listen to this. Read.
This is the book of Exodus, chapter 22 and verse 16.
Go ahead.
And if a man entice a maid.
So it says, if a man, like you, Matthew, if you spit game to a woman, you're trying to get in her ear, you're saying all the right things she want to hear. You tell her, you give her the moon, the sun, the world. I got a lot of money. And dudes lie, even though they don't, right? Read.
That is not betrothed.
And she's not promised to anyone. Right? Read.
And lie with her.
And lie with her. What do you think it means when a man lies with her? God says if you speak game to a woman and you get her draws and you have sex with her, that's what it means. Read.
He says surely endowed to be his wife.
God says you have to marry that woman you have sex with. That's right. A law in the Bible, Matthew.
Right.
The Bible is real. This ain't no Christian fairy tale game. You only knew that girl for 1 month, bro. And you said you already did all the things a married couple would do and you're not married. So, are you ready to marry that woman after just 1 month? According to the Bible. You say no, because like we read in Sirach, you have to get to know her first. You don't know what type of person she really is, bro. After 1 month, bro.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission. Minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.